we might be able to get up through the building.
It's worth a try.
Child you made with the Emperor.
Why, Mother? Why did you betray us all?
You have no right!
Answer him.
We took you in, savage. Show some respect for those who raised you. Honorable Elwyn. Always thinking of his precious homeland. But what worth is a homeland in a world beset by the Blight?
Father did not seek to protect his country. He sought to protect his people.
A leader's duty is not to protect his people. It is to protect the source of his sovereignty. The noble blood that runs in his family's veins. So long as this bloodline remains unbroken, what does it matter if a nation falls? One can always found another. Unlike him, I did my duty. I preserved my line. I bore a son of the noblest blood to whom the whole world might kneel. That is why I gave Rosaria to Sambrek, that I might join my line with the Lesages and birth a savior of this benighted land, blessed by both Bahamut and the Phoenix!
You sold your country for a child.
Why did he need another? You had Joshua.
I had nothing. You were always your father's son, so very strong and bold and daring. And yet you failed to awaken. Would that Joshua had been granted a tenth of your strength. Oh! How the nobles laughed that Elwyn's firstborn was surely the son of a concubine, and my own, not long for this world. The shame of it, the shame of being slandered by one's inferiors. How could you ever know how that feels? It should have been you! Why didn't the Phoenix choose you?
Joshua's every waking moment was spent trying to shoulder the burden that you and the Phoenix and the Duchy foisted on him. That's why I became his shield. To help bear the weight. But what did you do? You betrayed your own blood and surrendered your son to his fate!
Joshua, my darling boy. I never meant to hurt him. The soldier's orders were clear. He was to be spared. Why did you survive when the only one I truly cared for died?
What? Have you not looked out of the window? Joshua is here! The Phoenix lives on! He's battling Bahamut as we speak! Joshua! Wake up! I am a shield of Rosaria. And I will do my duty.
What are you...
my people.
Thank you.
Thank the Founder!
Thank you.
This is drinking me.
We have to stop him.
Thank you.
Joshua!
Joshua!
Clive!
My brother.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You're alive. We both are. Nothing else matters. I never dared hope that I would see this day.
Reunited at last.
Jill!
It is done. The demon that would tear our house apart is no more. Father.
The Mother Crystal. It's collapsing.
Right. We need to leave.
No. Wait. I owe him a debt.
Fine.
Nothing been done to call them off.
I regret not, Your Radiance. The Dragoons answer to none but His Imperial Highness. The Council is powerless to intervene. We're hearing
reports of rebel madness is this, Dion. Focus all efforts on extinguishing the fires around the capital. City can wait.
Don't dally, man! Go!
Your Radiance.
And I want you to find out.
Make sure the doors are locked. Makes
movements.
By the light, Dion, have you taken leave of your senses? Call off the dragoons at once.
Fear not. The populace will come to no harm at their hands. I am here to save you, Father.
Save me?
A creeping darkness hides in the heart of Senbrek. It stems from your wife, the traitorous Annabella.
Not another word, Dion.
Father, though you may not see it, the darkness has taken hold of you. It has made you forget yourself. But I bid you remember, there was a time when you ruled not with cruelty, but with compassion. Why now do you turn your back on your people? Why now do you seek to stoke the fires of war? You too have borne witness to this change, Your Eminences. And you know, as well as I, who is responsible for it. A puppet now sits upon the throne. But cut his strings, and the master loses the power!
What?
Dion, you bear steel before your emperor?
Guards! Take him!
For every citizen who falls, another can be bred. For every home that burns, another can be built. Those were your words. But when the last of your citizens has fallen, and all of their homes have been reduced to ash, what will become of your empire, of its rulers, of your god? As the mother crystals crumble one by one, and the blight sweeps in to claim all that we hold dear, our people look to their emperor for protection. Yet he labors not to secure their futures, but to seize what is left of the twins for himself. Even if it should come at the cost of everything his loyal citizens have labored to build.
Dion, you must understand.
A small price to pay, is it not? You've been blessed with great power, Dion. Enough to win me the world. So go, claim Valestia for me, brother.
Yeah.
Poor father. How he doted on his children. That he would die to protect me was plain. It was but a matter of when.
You planned this?
You did well to endure so long. But you broke in the end, as I knew you would. And now Muthos approaches. Put him to the proof. I would see if he breaks. Go, Bahamut. Kinslayer.
Cannot stay here, Mother. Come. Take my hand.
Get away from me! This is all just a dream, just a bad dream! You will not take me, Shadow! You will not take me!
Mother.
Consciousness that weaves your wills together. Consciousness that blurs the boundary between your own will and that of others. Then we shall set you apart once more. The ties that bind you shall be severed, and humanity return to its proper place. Primogenesis shall a new age of reason begin.
Relax, Your Majesty. Don't you want to play? It's been a long time.
If that is your wish.
Men, you are as meek as all the others.
Such feeble creatures.
gifted the power of icons, yet slaves to fickle emotions which usher you to your doom. And so you bind your fragile wills with strands of consciousness.
The wretched handiwork of a wretched people.
The Sons of Fire were united at last, and for but a moment, their flame burned bright. Soon, Muthos shall become our perfect vessel.
And then shall the world be remade.
Not before the bonds are severed, of trust, of respect, of love. Only when every strand of consciousness is cut away, may Muthos return to our side. By primogenesis shall all be undone. Mankind shall be rid of his wretchedness, and Muthos of his will. But while he yet clings to it, he has the power to forge bonds anew. And so we bid you. Find Muthos, and sever everyone.
To destroy that which has no physical form, you ask the impossible.
There is nothing your black blade cannot cut, Odin. We shall unite with Muthos, and bring forth a new world. So long as our vessel remains unclaimed by humanity.
It shall be done, Master. My will is yours.
How is your brother?
Asleep since I returned from the Dominion. Tyre says he should be back on his feet soon enough. For a while, at least. She discovered something on his chest. A swelling, circled in stone.
The curse. For every mountain we climb, another rises up to greet us, doesn't it?
It's never ending. Even the sky seems to have grown tired of it all.
If I disturb Joshua while he rests, I might as well see what Otto has to say. Hopefully it's nothing. But I should speak to Blackthorn just in case. What could be wrong with Torgor? He seemed well enough when I last saw him. Trouble with the ledgers. Shouldn't he be asking Otto for help? Blackthorn, do you have a moment?
Not really, no.
This won't take long. I just wanted to ask how you're getting on. August was worried about you, that you might still be doubting your craft, even after learning the trick of that cuirass. Is there something else weighing on your mind? Perhaps sharing your thoughts might help.
That bastard's like a dog with a bone. Still, you've got a keen eye, I'll give him that. He's just, well... Karen showed me something. Something I've never seen before.
And that was?
A sword. An odd-looking thing with a single-edged blade. The metal itself wasn't anything to write home about, but fuck me. The edge on it. You could slice a man clean in two with a weapon like that, and he'd be halfway home before he even realized he'd been cut.
So that's what's troubling you?
Nah. Not troubling me exactly, more distracting. Can't stop thinking, how do you get an edge that sharp? It's driving me mad.
And if you knew how to do it, we could arm the curse breakers with even better blades.
That's about the size of it, yeah.
I'll see what I can find out. Sharper swords are always welcome, and we can't have our master blacksmith being distracted.
You're a soft touch, you know that. But I can't say I'm not grateful for it. Good luck, eh?
Thank you. Let's see what Karen knows about this sword.
Yep. What do you want? Not bad, if I do say so myself.